Thomas Addison, April 1793, June 29, 1860, is a 19th century English medical scholar. He has discovered a number of diseases, including primary adrenal insufficiency, named as Edison's disease, and malignant anemia. Its inception and education. Thomas Addison was born in April 1793 in Longbenton, near Newcastle upon Tyne. His father, Joseph Edison, was a grocery storekeeper and merchant in Longbenton. He joined the Thomas Ritter School in the town and moved to complete his primary education in Newcastle upon Tyne, where he learned Latin and excelled in speaking and writing. Edison enrolled in medicine at the University of Edinburgh in 1812, contrary to his father's desire to be a lawyer. In 1815 he received his medical degree and his dissertation in Latin Dissertatio, Medica, Inauguralis, Quaedam, Syphilide, Hydrargyro, Completens on Syphilis and Mercury. His career in the same year. Edison moved from Edinburgh to London to work as a surgeon at Lock Hospital and was educated at Dr. Thomas Pittman, 1778-1821, at the public clinic. Edison was influenced by his teachers, and passion for the skin was a passion for the rest of his life and led him to describe changes in skin pigmentation in what was later known as Addison Guy Hospital in 1817. Edison enrolled as a trainee at the famous London Guy Hospital. His enrollment in the medical school of Guy has proved in his records. December 13, 1817, from Edinburgh, T. Addison, a doctor, paid £22 and paralyzed when to become a medical trainee. Edison followed this by obtaining the Royal College of Physicians 1819 and was later elected a Fellow of the Royal College. On January 14, 1824, Addison was promoted to an assistant doctor and in 1827 he was appointed as a lecturer on medicinal materials. In 1835, Edison became an associate professor of practical medicine with Richard Bright, 1789-1858. In 1837, he became a full physician at Guy Hospital. When Bright retired from teaching in 1840, Edison became the only lecturer and remained in office until 1854 or 1855, almost completely engaged to his students and patients. He was one of the teachers who trained the students' parents by teaching them, and his lectures were meant for a large number of medical students. His death. Edison suffered from frequent bouts of depression. It is likely that this eventually led to his retirement in 1860. And then to suicide by throwing himself from a high building on June 29 of the same year. References and margins.